Hello, Simon here, teaching you a little bit of the features that we use in Zoom, the video conferencing software. I'm going to whip through this really quickly. It's designed to be fast. Because you're watching it on YouTube, you can press the little settings icon, which is a little cog, and then change the playback speed. You can reduce it if you like, which might be a bit easier to keep up with me. Or you can pause it at any moment. So we are in Zoom, we're inside of a meeting. These are the features that are commonly available. Some of them down the bottom you might not be able to see straight away because you have to turn them on in the settings. I'll have another video where it talks about settings. I suggest you check that out. So first of all, when you join, usually you'll be starting in speaker view, which is this view here. Speaker view in a large group is just showing you whoever is talking at the time. So it's flicking between whoever's audio is the most active. A problem with that view is that you find you're not looking at the person you're supposed to be looking at. And so an option is to right-click the image itself, the video, or these three dots, and press pin video. It then means that one video, only one video can ever be pinned, is always seen by you. You control that, no one else sees the results of that. Another option is to go to gallery view. Gallery view is fantastic for large groups. You'll see every single person in the group. You'll see their video or just, as you can see with Amy, who is really just my phone, and I've called it Amy, just their icon or their image. Next is the audio settings down the bottom left here. It's a little microphone. To mute, you click on it, or as you can see with the tooltip that's hovering over the top there, Alt-A. Alt-A will also mute and unmute. While muted, you can press and hold the space key, which will allow you to talk, as you can see there. Letting go again puts you back to mute. Very useful when you're in a group environment, you just want to drop in or drop out of a conversation without having to fiddle around. Here are all the audio settings that you can choose from. Be aware that you can select different microphones. So I'm using this microphone connected to my headphones, but my computer also has a built-in microphone. So make sure you choose that when you're setting things up. It sometimes is a problem people miss. They don't realize that they're being taken through the wrong microphone. You can also choose the output, which is the speakers, or in this case, the headphones, as you can see there. Here are the audio settings. You can pause the screen to see these, but I'll close them now. I'll always suggest in every video, check the settings. Always look at the settings of everything. It tells you a lot more about what software can do. One thing to note as well for audio is this little mark down the bottom left of a video. If that red microphone with a line through it is on, you are muted. People in conversations might not realize they're muted. Pay attention to that little mark. That's what will happen if no one can hear you. Next is video. Very similar. Press the button to turn off your video. Press the button to start it again. Alt-V, as you can see through the tooltip, is how you turn it on with the keyboard. Here are the settings. Much fewer here, but if you press video settings, you've got more options. Check those out. One of the options within that is to turn on the virtual background. Now I'm going to turn on very quickly to show you what it looks like. There you go. You can choose images and upload them. The point of this is if you've got private information behind you that you don't want people to see, like statistics or people's names, or if you're in a messy bedroom. You can see it's not perfect, but it can be quite useful. So I'll turn that off. Next, we have the invite button. Press the invite button, you get options for once a meeting has started, bringing people in. So you can choose people from your contact list. You can also add them after meetings to your contact list. You can email them. Pressing one of these buttons will open up the corresponding application with a little bit of pre-written information you can send to people. If you copy the URL with that button there, I'll show you it in the chat, paste it, you get that link. Someone clicks that link, they're sent straight into this meeting. Copy the invitation, that button does this. The link, as well as a meeting ID, which can be used to join. I'll show you that in the setting up video that we're creating. So that's invite. Next is manage participants. By choosing that button, you're able to see a list of everybody in the conversation right now, as well as the status of their microphone and their camera. As a host of a video, so the person who set up the conference call, you can make some more options. You can mute them, you can unmute them, you can change their video. So that's quite useful. Something worth pointing out is that in the participants button, so let's get Amy, who's currently on this call with me. If you press the participants panel and open it up, there is the option to raise your hand, which in this version, you can see just there, raise hand. If I raise my hand, you'll see on the right here, as the host, I see a little hand go up. Everyone can see that icon. As the host, You can then see that someone's raised their hand and call them out. Very useful for big groups where everyone's on mute. Stops kind of everyone trying to fight over one another to get their say. So now the participant lowers their hand. I'll put them back away. Thank you, Amy. So if you ever get lost, manage participants or participants is where you find the raise hand feature. On your phone, you might have to go to the more button and see that as an option. Or when you press manage participants, there's less real estate on a phone, so you might have to go looking for it, but it should be there. Next is the share screen feature. Incredibly important, especially now that we're trying to replicate in-person meetings. So there's a couple of options for sharing the screen. I'll press the button to open it. I have two monitors, so you can share one monitor or the other, and you'll just see everything that appears on that screen. Another pretty useful option is the share application option, which I'll show you. So here you can see just Word, just a Word doc that I have open on the computer. If I press that and share it, I'll now show you what Amy would see. Amy sees this. Just the Word application, which is on my other screen, so I'll bring that onto the screen for you. That's what she's seeing. So that means I can do a bunch of stuff in the background. As you can see, my cursor is hovering around on the right. Amy can't see it. That is a useful feature for when you want to show particularly, say, a PowerPoint presentation. While you're showing the PowerPoint presentation and sharing that, you can still do a bunch of things on your computer. One more quick option is the whiteboard, which more people I think should use because it's a great feature. You can draw on it like a normal whiteboard, add text, use stamps. Stamps could be useful for, say, everyone choosing something they like or something they don't like. The spotlight allows you as the host to show where your mouse is at any given time. And the arrow, everyone can use this arrow, and it just shows people where they're looking as a user. There's more features there that you can play with. The best thing about it, though, is it's collaborative, so other people can annotate the whiteboard and let you all draw ideas or write ideas together in one centralized place. Very useful. There are some other advanced features here, which you can see they pretty much are what they say they are. You can explore those yourself, but portions of screens allow you to literally use this green box to choose the portion of the screen that's being seen. And then sound only or a second camera. So with second camera, that allows you to, say, have a second webcam or laptop peering out into a group. You can just send your audio, but then have the second camera being shared to everybody, allowing you to see a speaker or a different angle or the people out in the audience. You can also share files. Here are some options within sharing that you can pick and choose, so have a look at those. Next is chat. Chat's very useful, should always be activated, and if you're a guest or a part of a Zoom, have it turned on so you can see what's going on. The quick features of a chat is that you can send it to everyone, as you see there. Hi all. That's going to go to everybody, and they'll see that it's sent to everybody. But you can also send it to an individual privately, as you can see there. Hi Amy. If I send that to Amy, Amy's the only one that will see it. She can then click my name and respond to me privately. No one else in the Zoom sees it, so it's a good way to have little private conversations that maybe aren't appropriate for the session. If you're a host of a Zoom, pay attention to the conversation as it's happening, because you might want to be able to draw some interesting information out of it. It's also a way for people to contribute while someone else is speaking. You can see you can also have both the chat and the manage participants panel on at the same time. You can use the divider to change the size of that, as well as that, the video. Next is the record feature, which you may have to turn on in the settings. Watch the settings video for that. Essentially starts recording in an MP4 format that gets saved to your computer. So there it is recording now. Privacy is a concern, so make sure you've asked people that you want to record and that they've given permission. Closed captioning is again a feature you have to turn on in the settings. You can assign people to do the typing, so they have to do the typing themselves. But you could assign a third party, like AI Media, which is a service in Australia, who will come join the conversation and do the closed captioned translation as you go, live captioning. Excellent for access. Next is breakout rooms. Really good feature that I want to introduce you to that not everyone knows. Again, something you turn on in the settings. It allows the host, this is something that needs to be moderated and controlled by a host, or it can be a bit messy. Let's say there's 10 people in this meeting right now. I can divide them into, say, a workshop of two, two working groups of five each. Manually, I'll create those rooms. You can rename each room, let's say red group and green group. You then can manually assign people. That also has the automatic assign feature. You'll open the rooms. What happens from the user's point of view, so from Amy's point of view, a little box will appear telling her she's about to be drawn in to a breakout room. She'll go in, she'll just see the five people in that room. The chat will only feature those five people. The other group, so say Amy's in red group, green group don't see the other, they don't see the chat. Then at the end of the conversation, either after a timed period or when the host decides to pull everyone back together, a little box will appear telling them that's about to happen. They all come back into their group of 10. Very useful for those very common workshops we've seen where, say, you divide people up if it were a physical space, have them each work on a butcher's paper with identifying key priority areas, and then coming back together to demonstrate what those areas are. Really useful feature. We've used it really well at Yakwik, so it's something worth exploring. Last fun little feature is the reactions. People always see those popping up and want to know where they are. So it's this reaction, it's this little face down the bottom. You press the button, you see it appears in my screen. You can also applaud. So thumbs up and applause. Why would you use these? Big group, everyone's say on mute, and you say, here's an idea I have, who likes it? People can give their thumbs up. Or not, and you can then engage that way. So very quick overview of some of the features inside of a meeting. We're going to be making other videos about other features of Zoom, so please have a look, watch it on YouTube, and let us know if you like what we're doing or if we can change things. Thanks.